The Heisman Trophy stands alone. For 56 years, football's ultimate symbol of individual achievement. The faces, the names, familiar memories, storybook exploits. Frozen moments full of glory, hope, and promise. They are the legends who captured the imagination of America. Once the Heisman touches you, it stays with you for the rest of your life. These are men whose heroics transcend the game. Plays framed forever by this fabled award. And now, today's hopefuls. Ty Detmer of BYU. Desmond Howard of Michigan. Casey Weldon of Florida State. And defensive lineman Steve Empman of Washington. Four young men who may be touched by the power, the magic of the Heisman Trophy. This is the Heisman Trophy Award Show, presented by AT&T.
And folks, we welcome you once again to the Heisman Room at the Downtown Athletic Club in Lower Manhattan. In just a moment, the presentation, the four leading candidates are here, but first we want to turn to the man who won the award in 1968, won it over Leroy Keyes of Purdue by the largest margin to this point in history in the Heisman voting, our own O.J. Simpson. O.J., you recall your thoughts and feelings on that day?
Thank you. Well, you know, actually, thank you very much. Thank you. Actually, my feeling when I won the award, I guess the first feeling was one of relief. I went into the season the leading candidate for the Heisman Trophy, and that's a lot of pressure. Every week, guys are pointing for you, and after being the runner-up my junior year, I desperately wanted the award, so I was a little relieved that I won the award. Then came joy, and then a certain satisfaction. When I got back here to the athletic club, I guess those feelings turned to apprehension and a little nervousness, because I got around here, I saw the pictures, and I read the plaques, and I got to meet some of these individuals, and I realized that, hey, I was joining a sort of like royalty, that instead of being knighted sir, that forever my name would be preceded with the words Heisman winner. And I noticed that with just about every guy that had won the award before me, they had gone on to become outstanding citizens. They excelled and got involved in the community, excelled in business, and we even had a war hero or two there. And I knew that I was cocky enough to know that I would do well in athletics, but I didn't know if I could live up to this legacy off the field. And I want to say to the four finalists, I think you all are winners. You all deserve the award, and warn the eventual winner that, hey, the pressure is just beginning. Congratulations and welcome to the club.
All right, OJ, thanks very much. Now let's officially meet the four players invited for tonight's announcement. From Brigham Young University, last year's winner, Ty Detmer, who'd like to join Archie Griffin as the only two-time winner of the Heisman. From Florida State, quarterback Casey Weldon, who's compiled a 16-2 record as a starter and had the Seminoles in contention for the national championship until late in the year. From Michigan, Desmond Howard, the all-purpose game-breaker who caught a Big Ten record 19 touchdown passes this season. He averaged almost a touchdown every third reception. And from the University of Washington, defensive tackle Steve Empman, who won the Outland and Lombardi Awards and has been a key player in the Huskies' bid for a national title. So, you've met the four players. When we come back, one of them will own the Heisman Trophy.
The Heisman Memorial Trophy Award Show, presented by AT&T, is brought to you by Acura Automobiles, experience precision-crafted performance, by the Prudential, come to the companies of the Prudential and build your future on the rock, and by AT&T, the right choice.
Hidden Valley Ranch of Thousand Oaks. Are you waiting longer for calls to connect? Fabricon Carousel Company of Glendale. Are you saving less than you'd hoped since leaving AT&T? We want you back. AT&T Pro Watts. A discount plan with very competitive prices. Switch now and get 1 month of long distance free. We want you back. Call 1-800-222-0400.
Acura would like to pose the following question. Could your heart benefit from the use of another 24 valves? The Acura Legend Coupe.
On the 12 days of Christmas, NBC will get to you.
12 crooks uncaptured.
11 clues uncovered.
10 suspects sneaking.
9 costume changes.
8 bugs are leaping.
7 walls are leaking.
6 fishes flattened.
5 ceiling fans.
4 windows smashed.
3 swinging ties.
2 tons of fun
in a holiday network friendly.
John Candy, Who's Harry Crumb? NBC Sunday.
Okay, without further delay, let's go to Bill Blum, the president of the Downtown Athletic Club, who moments ago was given the official results of the Heisman voting by Deloitte and Touche independent auditors. Bill?
Thank you, Bob. It is my pleasure, on behalf of the members, the Board of Governors, and the offices of the Downtown Athletic Club, as well as the 917 national electors, to announce the winner of the 1991 John W. Heisman Memorial Trophy, awarded to the outstanding college player in the country. And this year's winner is Michigan's Desmond Howard. Congratulations, Desmond.
I would like to thank God for blessing me with two wonderful, great, and supportive parents, Hattie Dawkins, James Howard. I love you very dearly. I'd also like to thank Coach Bo Schembechler, who without him I wouldn't be at the University of Michigan, Coach Gary Moeller, and the coaching staff for doing a great job with us this year. I'd also like to thank President Duderstadt and the University of Michigan for acknowledging me of the great strides of African Americans of the past to put me in the position that I'm in today. And I'd just like to take this opportunity to dedicate this trophy to the 1991 Michigan Wolverine football team, because this was done through a team effort. Hail to the victors and go blue. Thank you.
His parents in Cleveland, Ohio, a short time ago, and when we come back, we'll talk with Desmond.
We believe that a luxury sedan should appeal to a driver's appreciation of soft leather, fine wood, and beautiful stretches of asphalt. The Acura Legend Sedan.
To Grandpa from Andrew. Anything you'd like to say, honey?
Yeah, but I want to see Santa. And there's this new kid at school. And it snowed 400 inches the other day.
Come on, Andrew.
Is Claire hiding again? It's like when I was little.
This weekend, any AT&T out-of-state call is just 11 cents a minute. From 5 p.m. Friday to 5 p.m. Sunday.
Say hello.
Because some gifts...
Grandpa!
Just can't wait.
I want to see Santa.
So call this weekend. AT&T, all you need to reach out.
Of constant change, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock, the Prudential, rock solid.
With O.J. Simpson and the Heisman winner, Desmond Howard of Michigan, I'm Bob Costas. Here are the final totals. Desmond had 2,077 total points. Casey Weldon of Florida State was second. Last year's winner, Ty Detmer, third. Steve Empman, fourth. And Shane Matthews, fifth. Now, O.J.'s margin of victory, 1,750 points over Leroy Keyes of Purdue in 1968, remains the largest margin.
Yes!
However, there were more electors then, and actually Desmond has polled the highest percentage of first place votes ever. He got 640 of a possible 753. That's 85%. The Juice had 82% of the first place votes in 68, and Tony Dorsett had 81% of the first place votes in 1976. The obvious first question, your reaction.
It feels great, you know, to be recognized as the outstanding player in college football today, and to see my mom's reaction on TV, I think, really summarizes it.
I think we're going to take a look at it as it was officially announced. It's been a foregone conclusion for a while, but there's your mom, Hattie.
That sums it up right there.
Now, we're going to go out there live, and let's see if we can talk to your mom, Hattie, and your dad, J.D. Mr. Howard, your thoughts? We can tell from the beaming smile.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, he symbolized Ever pretty good, and I had to go along with his mother. She's a great woman.
Anything you would like to say to your son here?
Desmond, you don't fulfill two-thirds of my life, and you only got that one-third to go, and that's finishing Michigan. All right.
Anything you'd like to say in return?
I know it's a very exciting moment in my house in Cleveland for them, and it's emotional back there. I'm just glad to see all of them are in the same house together and like they are at the games for me and supporting me like they are and have been through the majority of my life.
The question that has to be asked, you have a year of eligibility remaining, but you're on schedule to graduate in May. The last four, counting you, Heisman winners have been juniors. Two of the last three came out. What are you going to do?
I plan on attending the University of Michigan next year to pursue my degree in sociology, a PhD in sociology.
You know, Rocket Ismail, who did not win last year but came close, finished second behind that man over there, Ty Detmer, said the same thing and no doubt sincerely. But then when that money is waved in your face from the NFL and from Canada and you think about the situation, and you think about the Heisman and the bargaining position, that may be a tough decision to stick to.
It may be a tough decision, but it's not in my thought process right now. Only thing that's at the forefront of my mind is getting my degree in May and going out there and playing a tough Washington team in the Rose Bowl.
Let's get back to the Heisman here. At what age? I mean, when I went to Heisman, I never even thought about it until my senior year. When did you think that you had a chance, really, that this became a realistic goal for you?
I think after the Notre Dame catch, it became a realistic goal, but I didn't think I would win it. But, you know, through the notoriety and things that was coming through the nation from that one catch, I thought I was a viable candidate.
Let me jump in quickly here. We want to get a quick word from your coach, Gary Moeller, who's standing by in Ann Arbor. Gary, we don't have very long at all, and I know, like Desmond, your thoughts are on the Rose Bowl and Washington and the possibility of things break right of a national championship, but a word for your player.
He can't hear me.
He can't hear us. The folks in Chrysler Arena obviously whooping things up again. Our congratulations to you, Desmond Howard, the winner of the Heisman Trophy for 1991. Due to the length of today's football game, we were unable to bring you the story of 1961 Heisman Trophy winner Ernie Davis. We'll have it for you tomorrow during our NFL coverage. That's all from the Downtown Athletic Club. Stay tuned for NBC's Saturday Night Lineup and for O.J. Simpson and the Heisman winner Desmond Howard. So long.
American Airlines has furnished travel arrangements for the preceding program and is proud to be the official airline of the 1991 Heisman Memorial Trophy. American Airlines, something special in the air.
The preceding has been a presentation of NBC Sports, network of the games of the 25th Olympiad.
Hi, I'm Steve Martin, and I'll be hosting Saturday Night Live with my musical guest, James Taylor.
That's who you are.
Wednesday, NBC's making your holiday special when Bob Hope brings on Macaulay Culkin, Reba McEntire, and the AP All-American team. Bob Hope's Christmas, NBC Wednesday.
Mike Rozier of the Atlanta Falcons warming up before today's game with Seattle. He is one of seven Heisman Trophy winners currently active in the NFL. Rozier won the award in 1983 after starring at Nebraska. Now, obviously, just about everyone who wins the Heisman Trophy, as Desmond Howard did yesterday, goes on to a career in the NFL. One of the rare exceptions was the great Syracuse running back, Ernie Davis. Gail Gardner has the tragic story of a remarkable man.
Our day will come.
That was his song and his hope for the future. In 1961, Ernie Davis became the first black athlete to ever win the Heisman Trophy, and John F. Kennedy recognized him as a true American hero. Ernie was looking ahead to a career in pro football and a life with his college sweetheart, Helen Gott. His name was on the lips of every football fan in America.
He was so special, you know, and such a great kid. He just effervesced enthusiasm, and he had that wonderful smile. If there ever was a perfect kid, it was Ernie Davis.
This kid from Elmira, New York, was on his way to the pros. Signed by the Cleveland Browns, he would join his fellow Orangeman Jim Brown in the backfield. But by the spring of 1962, everything changed.
I received a call from a doctor and said that he had devastating news for me, that they've diagnosed Ernie's case not as mumps, but as acute monocytic leukemia, the most virulent kind of leukemia for a youngster.
When you found out that he had some kind of an illness, it just, you couldn't believe that. And you also felt that he was gonna overcome it. I mean, nobody in that kind of condition, that healthy looking, can be that sick.
As we were walking down the street, a fan came up to Ernie and said, "Are you Ernie Davis?" And Ernie says, "No," because we were, I guess we were on our way to dinner somewhere else. And he says, "No." And the fan says, "You should be glad that you're not Ernie Davis, because he's going to die." And Ernie looked at the fan and said, "I am Ernie Davis, and I'm not going to die."
But all the will in the world couldn't save Ernie Davis. He died on May 18th, 1963. The funeral was a most heartfelt outpouring. For Ernie's mother, who lost her only child, it was the words of a priest that kept her going.
He said, "Now, you know, if you went into a flower garden to pick flowers, you would pick the prettiest and the best." Well, I said, "Yes." So he said, "Well, now, that's the way God is. When he comes to get flowers from his garden, he picked the best."
So sad, yeah. Sad evening.
There are perpetual flowers on Ernie Davis's grave. His Heisman opened the floodgates for all the great black athletes that would follow. Each one of them carries a little bit of Ernie Davis's legacy in his heart. O.J. Simpson, Archie Griffin, Tony Dorsett, Earl Campbell, and so many more were witness to his courage and integrity. And what better weekend to honor the memory of this extraordinary Heisman winner? Happy birthday, Ernie Davis. We haven't forgotten.
Yes, Ernie Davis would have been 52 yesterday, which turned out to be Heisman Trophy Day for 1991. Juice, you won the award 7 years after he did. He had some meaning for you, right?
Yes, you know, I first became aware of the Heisman, really what it was all about, because of Ernie Davis being the first black recipient of the award. And I recall, even though I never saw him play other than in highlights around that time, in the park we were all debating, you know, "I'm Jim Brown, I'm Ernie Davis," and the big question was, "Well, who's going to block?" I said, you're Brown, you're block, you're going to block, I'm Ernie Davis, I'm going to run the ball," and vice versa. So it was just sad that I never got to see him play in real life.
What an amazing backfield that would have been.
Yeah, I saw him play at Syracuse, Bob, against Boston College once. But I think a great story about him is Modell told me earlier today that Ernie Davis, when he was sick and he was going to treatments twice a week, would always call Ott Modell on the phone and say, "I'm sorry, Mr. Modell, I'm taking your money and I'm not playing." And this went on and on. But suddenly one day Ernie Davis was in his office and his secretary said, "Ernie's here," and Modell brought him in and said, "Champ, why are you here today?" And he says, "Well, I just want to say goodbye." And 3 days later he died.
And we'll continue right after this.